What's up, everyone? Welcome to the Surfside PPC YouTube channel. Today is going to be my complete keyword research tutorial for 2020. This is part 4 of my SEO tutorial for beginners, so make sure you catch up on the earlier parts if you haven't already. For this video, I'm going to be going over keyword research for SEO, but you can apply a lot of these same concepts directly to your PPC advertising campaigns. For this specific video, I'm going to be showing you how to come up with a keyword list, and I'm going to be doing it for my website, floorjackcenter.com. So I'm just getting started with trying to increase my organic search traffic to floorjackcenter.com. And one of the main things you want to do when you're trying to do that is keyword research. So at the end of this video, I'm going to show you how to come up with a keyword list that looks something like this one. So as we scroll down here, you're going to see there's a lot of different keywords here that we want to create content around so that ultimately we can rank higher in search engines. So to get started with this video, what I want to do is I want to go over some of the top free keyword research tools that you can use. The top two that I use the most are Google Keyword Planner and Ubersuggest. Both are completely free. Google Keyword Planner, in order to get all the information in the Keyword Planner, you do need an active Google Ads campaign. So you want to make sure you have an active Google Ads campaign, even if it's not spending, that will allow you to see all of that data. Ubersuggest, you want to sign in with your Google account, and I'll show you how to use both of these tools for this video. Now, three other tools that I like to use: Word Tracker, KeywordTool.io, and then Google and YouTube Autocomplete. So to go over these free keyword research tools, the first thing I want to do is show you, I have a video here of the best free keyword research tools. I will put the link in the description for this video so you can look at all these different free keyword research tools. And if you come down here to the description, you're going to see there's 14 free keyword research tools, and you'll see all of them right here. To quickly go over some of these different keyword research tools, the first one is the Keyword Planner. You're going to find this directly in your Google Ads account. So if you're going to see here the last 30 days, this is an account I just use for tutorials. So you're going to see right here, I have a couple of campaigns running. They're not really active. I have 50 impressions for one over the last 30 days. I've only spent $2.07 over the last 30 days, and I'm still able to see all of that data in the Keyword Planner. So what you want to do is sign into your Google Ads account or create one if you don't have one already, and then come up here to Tools and Settings. And then what we're going to do is come down to Planning and click on Planning, and you want to find the Keyword Planner right here. Okay, so when you come into the Keyword Planner, it's going to look something like this. And then the other keyword research tools that I went over are Ubersuggest. So this is neilpatel.com/Ubersuggest, or you could just go directly to Ubersuggest.com. The other one is wordtracker.com. So this will give you a lot of keyword ideas as well. KeywordTool.io, which the best part about this is you can look up keywords in Google, YouTube, Bing, Amazon, eBay, and more. So you're able to find a lot of different keywords, and it uses things like Google Autocomplete and YouTube Autocomplete. Now, I like using Google Autocomplete and YouTube Autocomplete manually. So basically what that means is when you come in here, and let's just say I come up to YouTube and I'm searching a keyword like carjack. So I'm trying to find some keywords related to this business, floorjackcenter.com. I come up to search and I do carjack and just click on space. You're going to see all these different keyword ideas here. Now, if I come over here to Google and I search carjack directly into Google, you're going to see this is what autocomplete is right here. And then you also have the searches related to carjack at the bottom. So these are all similar keywords related to carjack and really long tail variations of a short tail keyword. So what we want to do to get started is go over the importance of keyword research. So if we come back over here, these are the free keyword research tools that I use, but why you should do keyword research. For SEO, you want to find the top searched keywords for your business. When you find what people are actually typing into search engines to find products and services that you offer, you want your website front and center so you can drive people to your website, because that's going to allow you to drive sales and drive leads. Now, the other thing you can do is PPC. So find keywords that can drive sales and leads at the top of the search results. So if we come back over here and we're in our carjack example, we come to the top, you're going to see these are advertisements right here. We keep coming down. And if we come to the bottom of the page, you're going to see here are some different advertisements as well. So either one of these ways is going to help you drive more leads and sales for your business. Keyword research is a vital aspect of growing any business online, because the keywords that people are typing in can help you drive sales for your business. So we're going to come back over here, and getting started, I recommend using Microsoft Office or a free alternative. So a couple of free alternatives here. You can use LibreOffice, so LibreOffice.org. This is a free version of Microsoft Office. And then you can also use Google Drive. So you just sign into your Google Drive account and you can set up a personal account here, open Google Drive, and you can create spreadsheets in your Google Drive account 100% free. For this video, I'm going to be using Microsoft Excel, so you do have to pay to use Microsoft Office, but if you don't want to pay for Microsoft Office, you can use some of those free alternatives. The other thing you want to do is use Google Keyword Planner or Ubersuggest, or use both. So I would recommend using one or the other, but you can use both if you want to. Ubersuggest pulls in a lot of the same data from the Keyword Planner, so if you don't want to go through the process of creating a Google Ads account and signing into the Keyword Planner, Ubersuggest is a great alternative. And then what you want to do, last but not least, is use your website and use the top keywords for your website to continue to expand your keyword list. And you want to group together keyword ideas. So the goal of keyword research, find the top keywords for your business, group keywords based on theme. I can't stress this enough how important it is to group keywords based on theme. And then last but not least, this is after you do all of your keyword research, is you want to create content around the keywords for your business. And the final goal here, this is really what we're looking to do, is you want to pull some of these short tail, really popular keywords like car jacks, like pallet jacks, or whatever the top keywords are for your business, and then find some of these secondary keywords related to them. So some of these long tail keywords, low profile car jack stands, 3-ton car jack, and then the same thing for pallet jacks or apply it to your business, whatever the top keywords are for your business. So what we're going to do first is we're going to come over here and we're going to open the Google Keyword Planner and we're going to click on Discover New Keywords. So we could either start with keywords or we can start with a website. So if we start with keywords here, what you want to do is enter the top keywords for your website. If you start with a website here, you just want to enter your website right into this line. So I'm going to start with my website and we're going to take my website right here, copy the URL, paste it, use the entire website, and then get results. You can also do use only this page if you're looking to expand on a single keyword and trying to find some of those more long tail variations. So we click on get results here. And if we come down here, what you're going to see is it's going to first pull in the top keywords by relevance. So these ones are the keywords that I already rank for, some of the keywords that Google thinks are the most relevant for my website. So if I scroll down, you're going to see these are keywords that Google finds really relevant to my website. Now what I can do is just sort by average monthly searches and pull the keywords that have the most average monthly searches that are related to the products that are on my website. So you can see keyword ideas here, car jack, floor jack, car lift, hydraulic jack, by average monthly searches. So you can see there's a good amount of search volume for this particular category. And what we can do is download keyword ideas, and that's gonna pull in these 1200 keyword ideas. Now, the other option that we have is we can come over here to the top bar and start with keywords, and then take some of these keywords down here at the bottom, like car jack, like floor jack, like hydraulic jack, and type them directly into this line here. So what I'm gonna do is do car jack. Okay, so enter some keywords here, car jack, hydraulic jack, really pulled in some of these top keywords here by average search volume. And what I'm going to do is not use my domain to use as a filter. I'm going to get rid of this here because I want to come up with a large keyword list. So we're going to click on get results. Okay, so what you're going to see is we can pull in keywords by relevance, but what I like to do is just pull in keywords by average monthly searches. Now you can see we have 4,900 keyword ideas rather than just the 1,200 keyword ideas we had previously. You really don't need thousands and thousands of keyword ideas. You really just want to focus on the top 200, 300, 400 keywords for your business and then slowly chip away and create content around those keywords. So here are the keywords I provided, car jack, car lift, floor jack. And then as we scroll down, you're going to see more of these keyword ideas here, and we can continue to scroll down, you're going to see more and more keyword ideas, things that I didn't type in, things that have a lot of average monthly searches. So I prefer to first enter my website and then enter some of these top keywords for my website and then any other related keywords that you know about. So as you're selling products and services, if I know, for example, I come in here and I say, okay, well, I do have pallet jacks on my website as well, so we'll enter that as a keyword. So you can enter any keyword here that's going to help you expand your keyword list and then click on get results, because it's only going to help you get more and more keywords related to your business. So what we're going to do first is download keyword ideas. So I'm going to click on download here. Okay, so that's going to download an Excel file. So what I'm going to do is open that Excel file. So your Excel file is going to look something like this with your own keywords here. So you're going to see currency, average monthly searches, competition, bid ranges, and then searches per month over here. So generally what I'll do is I'll delete these top two rows at the top. So delete them, get rid of currency. So we'll delete that. The main two things I really focus on are keyword and average monthly searches. If you want to pull in any of these other columns here, one of the things you can do is pull in this top of the page bid range here. So you're going to see top of the page bid high range. So we'll delete these columns here. And what that allows you to see is, let's just say, for example, a keyword like floor jack gets about 50,000 average monthly searches. and the high range, the high bid on this keyword is $1.81, which really isn't that high of a bid. Now, on the other hand, Palette Jack, same amount of search volume, the high range for this keyword is $14.36. So generally what that means is advertisers are finding more value for those keywords. So if you want to use these top of page bids here, you can, because it allows you to see what's driving a lot of value to advertisers. So something where advertisers are bidding $14.36, even something where advertisers are bidding $4.32 as opposed to $1.81 really just shows you value. For this particular example, I'm not going to be showing the top of page bid. I'm really just going to focus on keyword and average monthly searches. So we're going to delete this over here. Okay, so we just have two columns here, keyword and average monthly searches. And we're going to take this column, we're going to center it, just make it look a little better, and we're going to expand this one. So the way I do keyword research is I focus on these main keywords at the top here that get a lot of average monthly searches. So what I'll do is I'll start by clicking on this column here. We're going to come to data and we're going to do sort. We're going to expand the selection, sort, and we're going to sort by average monthly searches. So ultimately what we're trying to do is we're trying to look at which keywords are getting the most average monthly searches. So we're going to do okay. And that's going to sort this by the keywords with the most average monthly searches. So what I do is I take these keywords right here and I start to insert rows beneath them because these are the keywords that I really want to focus on: car jack, car lift, floor jack, pallet jack. So we're going to insert rows here. And if we come back over to our example over here, this is ultimately what we're trying to do is find these short tail keywords that we really want to rank for and then find the long tail keywords that we can connect to these pages because I want to create different pages of content for these different types of categories. So someone looking for a 3-ton car jack, I want to create a page that's exactly set up for that person. Someone looking for a ride-on pallet jack, I want to set up a page that's exactly like that so that people can find the products that they're looking for. And then I'm going to link all of these different pages to this main page right here. So this is going to be the main page. This page is going to have a ton of content on it. It's going to link out to all these different pages because when someone types in pallet jacks, they might be looking for an electric pallet jack. They might be looking for a ride-on pallet jack. So I want to make sure I have a huge guide page right here. And then these secondary pages are going to help me link to this guide page. And then what Google is going to see and what other search engines are going to see is this website has content around this keyword and then all of these related keywords. So they're a good resource for somebody who is searching that type of keyword. So that's really the goal of keyword research, is to come over here and to group together these similar keywords like car jack, like car lift, like floor jack, and then find similar keywords to them. So for a quick example here, if we click insert right here, you'll see pallet jack. So electric pallet jack is going to go beneath pallet jack because pallet jack is ultimately a main category and then electric pallet jack is going to be a subcategory. So hopefully that really makes sense. That's really what I try to do with keyword research. So then I can come up with a list that looks like this one. So if we come up to the top, you're going to see car jack and then some of these different subcategory keywords that are going to help me rank for more and more keywords in search engines like Google. So ultimately what we want to do first is find these main categories of keywords that we want to rank for. So anything like this with really two words, hydraulic, bottle jack, pallet jack, any of these different types of keywords are going to be main categories for me. And then what I'm going to do is show you how I find these subcategory keywords using Google Keyword Planner and using Ubersuggest. So we'll come over here, we're going to insert a row above again. And what I'm going to do is pull out some of these top keywords right now. So once we have some of these main categories of keywords here, so I've separated mine here, as you can see, we're going to start finding some of these secondary keywords as well. And you can come down here and use some of these to find secondary keywords. But the easier way to do it, in my opinion, is just to take these main keywords. So something like car jack. And what we're going to do is we're going to come back over here to the keyword planner and we're just going to enter that one keyword. And we're going to be looking at the keywords that Google finds the most relevant. So we're going to click on get results first, and then we're going to add a filter and say the keyword text must contain car jack and click on apply. So what it's going to do is it's going to find the most relevant keywords. And you can see if we scroll down here, we have car jack and then we have lift, stands, Walmart, hydraulic, electric, car floor jack. So we're going to take all of these keywords and we're going to download keyword ideas for this specific search term. Okay, so our report is ready, so we're going to open this one now. And then all I do is we're just going to delete these two rows, just like I did previously. We're going to delete the currency column, and then we're going to delete all these other columns. Okay, so next what we're going to do is we're going to come over here to data, and we're going to sort again. So we're going to expand the selection, click on sort, and we're going to sort from largest to smallest again like we did previously. So we're going to do cell values, average monthly searches, largest to smallest, click on OK. and now we have our top keywords. So we're gonna get rid of these top two right here. So let's just say we're gonna do anything over 200 average monthly searches. We're gonna come down here. So we're gonna keep scrolling down. So we come and we're gonna do right here. So we're gonna start at 210. So anything over 200, we're gonna take that, we're gonna copy it, and then we're gonna come back over to our main spreadsheet and we're gonna paste it right in here. Okay, so now we have our keywords underneath carjack. And if we scroll down, you can see all of these different keywords are highly relevant to this main keyword right here. So we're gonna keep scrolling down. And the next thing we have is car lift. So we're gonna rinse and repeat the same exact thing we just did. So you're gonna come back over to the keyword planner, and instead of carjack, we're just gonna enter car lift, click on get results, and then we're gonna have to change this filter right here. So it might say no ideas satisfy current filters. So we're gonna click here on keyword text contains carjack and just change it to car lift and click on apply. Okay, so now we have the same exact thing here. We're gonna download keyword ideas again, and we're gonna come down here to the bottom. We're gonna open up this report, and we're gonna do the same thing we did previously. So clean up the spreadsheet a little bit. So we'll delete these rows, delete these columns. Okay, so we're gonna sort it again. So we're gonna come here to data, sort, and we're gonna expand the selection. And we're gonna sort by average monthly searches, largest to smallest, click on okay. And what we wanna do is we're gonna do the same thing. So anything above 200. So we can scroll down here. Now what you can do is you can come down and just say, okay, I'm gonna go anything above 90, anything above 100. And you can take all of these different rows here, copy them, come over to your keyword spreadsheet. So we're over here to car lift now, and then we're just gonna paste this right here. So we're gonna paste it there. And now we have all of these different keywords. And then one thing you can do is always go through all this and say, okay, I don't really want to focus on brand names, so I'm just going to take out something like Harbor Freight Car Lift. So that just really depends on your overall preferences. Now, one question you might have is, let's just say we have a main keyword of hydraulic jacks, hydraulic lift, car lift, any of these different main keywords, or maybe we're doing portable car lift. If you start to see some of these things have a little bit of overlap in one category here and another category here, don't really worry about it too much. Ultimately, what you want to do is just say, if you have something that's car lift, car jack lift, and you're wondering, how do I categorize this? Ultimately, what you want to do is just focus on these main pages. And then as you get into some of these secondary keywords, if you see any duplicates, just make sure that something like carjack lift is linked to this carjack page. And then as we scroll down, make sure something like portable car lift, if you're doing something like portable jacks, portable jack lift, anything like that, just make sure you link these things up as much as possible. The more you start to target keywords like this, and the more you put together your keyword spreadsheet and review all of your keywords, you're going to see a little bit of overlap. So don't worry too much about it. Just keep in mind that some of these things, like to post car lift, maybe I'm doing something like post lift as a main keyword. So we come here to post lift, we bold it, and we have something like to post car lift, which would work in this category and this category. So just take the to post car lift and apply it to both categories, and then just create one page for it. So it's really that simple. And the way to make this as easy as possible is, as you're setting up some of these different pages on your website, let's just say I'm doing something for 3-ton car jack. What I can do is over here, I can keep track of all these different URLs. So then if I'm doing something like creating a page on my website, I can just do 3-ton car jack. So then I know exactly the keyword that I'm targeting here. And then if I scroll down and I have another 3-ton car jack keyword in a different category, I can always look and make sure I have that page. If I already have that page on my website, just take it, apply it to both categories. And really, ultimately, what we're trying to do is we're trying to get to this point here. So where we have these main categories and then these subcategory keywords. This is the goal of keyword research, is to find these main categories and then the subcategories that are going to help you rank for the main categories and the subcategories. Because let's just say I come over here and we'll use this keyword spreadsheet. And let's just say I really want to rank for this keyword carjack, and I want to rank for all these secondary keywords. Let's just say I do equals sum. How many average monthly searches does this get? So we're going to come up to the top, and we're gonna click on enter. So now you can see there's 106,000 average monthly searches just for keywords related to carjack. And this is just the top keywords related to carjack. So there's probably even more searches related to these different keywords that we're finding for our business. So as I continue to set up more and more content on my website, and as I start to target these different keywords with my content, I'm gonna be able to rank higher in Google and other search engines, and I'm gonna be able to drive some of this search volume to my website. So even if I say, okay, maybe I'm getting 1% of this, so we're gonna say equals, and we'll use this number, and we're gonna say times 0.01. So 1% of this search volume is over 1,000 clicks per month to my website. And if you think about it, if you're paying for those clicks directly into Google and you're bidding a dollar per click, that's $1,000 that you'd have to spend. So that's why you want to do organic keyword research and then focus on creating content around these pages, because it's going to help you drive thousands of clicks to your website every single month. So this is really the goal of keyword research. And then what I try to do is come up with a spreadsheet like the one I showed you in the beginning. So you're going to see these main categories and then some of these subcategory pages, and just focus on your top keywords here. And then as you start to build out content for all these different main keywords, you can continue to expand the keywords that you're targeting. And what you want to do is, as you create more and more content, let's just say, for example, this year I put together 200 different pieces of content around all of these different keywords that I found. What you can do is come back over here to the Google Keyword Planner and then come in, start with a website, enter your website again, and you're going to realize there's more and more keyword ideas here that are going to be relevant to your website that have a lot of average monthly searches. And then anything with a high amount of average monthly searches, let's just say over 500 that you haven't already targeted, you can continue to target with new content in the following year. So the first part of keyword research is to find all of these different keywords for your business. And then what you want to do is start to create content around all these different keywords here. And as you continue to create that content in the following months, the following years, you can continue to expand that keyword list. So what I can do is come over here to Ubersuggest. Now, Ubersuggest is also great for expanding on some of these main keywords. So if I come in here and do enter a domain or keyword, so I'm going to open Ubersuggest in this window because I'm already signed in. Come here, enter floor jacks. So let's just say I want to expand on the keyword floor jacks, click on search. Okay, so we enter this keyword here. You can see the search volume, SEO difficulty, paid difficulty, and the average cost per click. So if we scroll down, you're going to see search volume. What I'd like to do is click here on keyword ideas. So you take your main keywords here and then you come to keyword ideas, and you're going to see they have keyword floor jacks, 3-ton, Harbor Freight, Walmart, Walmart, Lowe's, 2-ton, 4-ton, 4-ton floor jacks. And we continue to scroll down. You're going to see low profile, hydraulic for cars, best floor jack. So what you can do is copy to clipboard. So let's just say we take all these suggestions, copy to clipboard, and we come back over here. We come back over to our spreadsheet and you can see we have floor jack right here. So we're going to paste this in here. Okay, now you can see we have all these different keywords here directly from Ubersuggest, and this is already ranked by average search volume. I personally don't worry too much about this number right here that it's 170, 140. I really just focus on trying to rank what the top keywords are, so then I know as I'm creating content around car lifts, I know that people are looking for portable car lifts. People are looking for two-post car lifts, four-post car lifts. So some of these different things that people are looking for, it helps me kind of prioritize which keywords I should target with my content first. And as you start to get down here, sometimes you might find something like rotary car lift, for example, 880 average monthly searches that might not be as optimized for some of these main websites like Amazon, like Walmart, like Lowe's, like Home Depot. So some of these websites and Harbor Freight, they might not be as optimized for something like rotary car lift or four-post car lift, DIY car lift. So you might be able to create some content around these long tail keywords, and it's going to help you drive more traffic back to your website. So this is going to be SEO lesson number 4, how to do keyword research. I highly recommend using Ubersuggest. I highly recommend using the Google Keyword Planner. I have tutorials for the Google Keyword Planner on my channel. I will put those links in the video description. But really what you want to do is just find these keywords, and then you want to group together similar keywords. So you first start by doing a search for the main keywords, the products and services most closely related to your business, or just start with your own website. Take the main keywords, categorize them like I did. So you're going to see I have all these things categorized: car lift, you can see I have pallet jack, and then find those types of keywords by simply going to the keyword planner, entering the keyword here, and then using that filter right here. The keyword text contains car lift, so whatever you're looking up. So if I'm doing pallet jack, so keyword text contains pallet jack, click on apply, and then we come over here to search and we enter pallet jack here. And that's going to help you find all of these keywords, and then you can group them together, and it's going to help you find all these similar keywords. So for pallet jacks, you're going to start creating content around these different keywords for your business, and then you want to continue to improve that content over time. Now, in the next video, I'm going to be going over exactly how to create a keyword content map so you can map these keywords to the pages on your website, so you know exactly what you're trying to rank for on your website, and you can target some of these long tail and short tail keywords to continuously increase your organic search traffic. So this is my keyword research tutorial. I highly recommend using the Google Keyword Planner. Just coming in here, it's really easy to use. Enter the keywords, the products and services, the things that people are going to search to find your business. Regardless of what you're trying to offer, you can always use keyword research to find more and more keywords related to your business. And then as you come down here, start creating content around these keywords. So even if it's down here at the bottom, carjack extension, target carjack, lightweight carjack, just find some of these different keywords here and start to target them with your content. And that's ultimately the goal of keyword research and search engine optimization, is to create content around the top keywords for your business and consistently and continuously do it. And the better your content is, the more you keep your content up to date, relevant, and high quality, the higher you're going to rank in search engines. So if you have any questions about this, please leave them in the comment section. This is my keyword research tutorial for 2020. And just to quickly go over, one thing I want to go over one more time is group keywords based on theme. And then you want to create content around those keywords and then tie them all together by linking those subcategory pages to the main category pages. So as you put together your keywords for carjack lift, you're putting together content around all these different keywords, you link the hydraulic carjack page back to the carjack page. And then you can also link your carjack page to this hydraulic carjack page, because as search engines see that, they're going to say, okay, this website has comprehensive content around these top keywords, around these different topics. Ultimately, you're trying to create the best possible content around these topics to solve the problems that your customers are having. So as they look for a carjack and as they research carjacks, they find your website as a resource, because search engines realize that you have the most comprehensive and authoritative content. So thank you for watching my video today, and make sure you subscribe to the Surfside PPC YouTube channel.